Hi, and welcome to Healthitarian Living. On this video episode, I will be sharing with you a tutorial that is all about chocolate, but not just any chocolate, of course, but the source of chocolate, the cacao bean itself. In our society, we have a big fascination with chocolate. Perhaps for some of us, this stretches into a craving, an addiction, or simply a desire to experience the various aspects of this substance that we know as chocolate. And so in this video, I will help you understand first the cacao's original source of nutrition and health benefits. Then we will talk about conventional chocolate and how this varies from the original or source of the chocolate, the cacao itself. And so I will help you understand why conventional or common chocolate is in no way any kind of health food or a beneficial substance for your health. To benefit properly from the cacao, we again need to go to the source. And this is where I will share with you how to work with raw, natural cacao for various snack and treat ideas. And finally, I will also help you know how to make homemade chocolate that only takes a few minutes. And via the various snack ideas, as well as the homemade chocolate, you'll be able to enjoy chocolate in its most natural, wholesome, and healthiest of ways that is also extremely delicious. So the source of chocolate is the cacao bean. This is literally a plant part that is found in nature. And the Latin name for cacao is Theobroma, translation meaning the food of the gods. This valuable crop played an important role in many ancient South American cultures, especially in cultures like the Mayans and Aztecs. However, how they used the cacao bean is nothing like how we have come to use the cacao bean in the form of chocolate over the last roughly 100 years or so. So the cacao plant produces these beans, which then get processed into various forms. Minimally processed and the most natural forms of cacao would include something like cacao nibs, which is just the bean itself crushed down into smaller parts, or cacao powder, which is the cacao bean ground down into a powder. There's also cacao butter, as well as things like cacao paste that can be used. Now, these would be the most natural forms of how the cacao can be consumed. Of course, there are much more processed forms that all revolve around what we know typically as conventional or common chocolate. When it comes to the cacao bean's nutrition, it is very important to know that it is in no way the same as the nutrition or health benefits that are sometimes attributed to conventional chocolate. It is an excellent source of healthy fats, healthy proteins, and carbohydrates. The cacao bean also includes fiber. It is also rich in minerals, vitamins, antioxidants, and phytonutrients. These are typically what its health benefits are most hailed for. When it comes to the minerals, it is an excellent source of all of the different minerals that are essential for the human body, but especially shines in areas like magnesium, potassium, and chromium. With respect to the vitamins, it includes vitamin C, as well as a good host of the B vitamins. With respect to the antioxidants, cacao is known today as one of the most powerful antioxidant foods. In fact, it is cited as being anywhere from about 15 to 20 times more powerful with respect to its antioxidant activity compared to something like blueberries or even green tea. When it comes to its phytonutrients, being a plant food, it has numerous powerful healing, protective, preventative, and beneficial phytonutrients. Some of these include beneficial polyphenols and flavonoids. Now, one particular phytonutrient has seemed to cause quite a bit of confusion, that being caffeine. The cacao bean is essentially caffeine-free. However, what it does have is a different phytonutrient, a powerful alkaloid known as theobromine. It also is a powerful antioxidizer. And even though it has some qualities or characteristics that are similar to caffeine, in its essence, it is very different from caffeine. One of the biggest examples is that caffeine gives our body, especially our nervous system, a very strong jolt, has a very strong effect. Theobromine, on the other hand, even though it also is a stimulant, it has a gentle effect on the body and quite different in how it is assimilated and used by the body in general. And so this is what makes cacao less problematic and more beneficial, generally speaking, than something like the coffee bean And so when it comes to all of these phytonutrients, but especially theobromine, they have many beneficial effects on our health. Theobromine specifically, for example, is a blood vessel, especially capillary dilator. And this can have many positive benefits, including regulation of blood pressure, as well as increased absorption of nutrients. And so based on that short summary of cacao's nutritional benefits, what and how can our health benefit? Well, first and foremost, thanks to all those antioxidant powerful properties, it is outstanding for helping our cells and thus our organs, tissues, and body heal any of the damage that it undergoes on a daily basis, especially when it comes to interacting with free radicals that cause various types of damage, including DNA damage that can lead to cancer. And so this is just one awesome way that cacao can help. But of course, the antioxidant properties are also beneficial for our immune system, for our cardiovascular system, etc. Cacao is also highly beneficial for overall relaxation benefits or effects. Being high in magnesium, for example, it's a wonderful muscle relaxer. And so this can be helpful, especially for people who suffer, for example, from something like restless leg syndrome or any muscle spasms, cramps, or contractions. Going back to the cardiovascular system, cacao can help to optimize all aspects of our cardiovascular health, including help to lower and/or regulate healthy blood pressure as well as cholesterol. And from a mental or emotional perspective, cacao has been associated with being beneficial for our optimal cognitive function, including memory. It also has mood enhancing or mood balancing properties that can also bring about a sense of bliss or euphoria. Now, despite all of these and many other beneficial or wonderfully sounding benefits, when it comes to plants in our world, some of them are highly medicinal. So while some are touting its benefits, others are actually warning people about the toxicity of the cacao. Well, the same can be said about coffee. And who is right? Well, both and neither. You see, as with all things, it all depends on the quality of the substance that is being consumed, as well as the quantity, how much is being ingested and how often. Because like many herbs and mushrooms, medicinal foods are meant to be used sporadically or when needed as a medicine, not to be used like a food for everyday use. And this is one of the reasons why there's so much conflicting information when it comes to specifically coffee. But cacao has some of its own conflicting information, as I just shared with you as well, as these substances are simply not meant to be used daily or in large quantities. So before we get to the really fun and exciting part of how to work with cacao and enjoy its amazing benefits in the healthiest of ways, let's talk about conventional or common chocolate first and its many problems that make it so far removed from any kind of health food. Not even the dark conventional common chocolate that is marketed to us is or can be considered as any kind of health food. Why is this? Well, a simple scan of the ingredients will tell us everything we need to know. But before we look at the ingredients, let's understand the first problem with any common conventional chocolate and why it is in no way equivalent to using the cacao in its raw and least processed form. You see, conventional chocolate is processed typically based on the Dutch alkali process. The beans are roasted and then treated with a strong alkali salt, something like potassium carbonate typically. Then further high heat milling is applied, and then more processing and heat treatment depending on the specific needs. So why is this a big deal? Because many people are eating the chocolate, well, aside from their desire for the flavor and feeling, for its health benefits. But this very process has been estimated by studies to reduce anywhere from about 70 to 98% of the cacao bean's nutritional benefits. And this impacts most specifically the antioxidants that the cacao is so highly acclaimed for. But it also impacts the vitamins as well as the minerals, which are highly denatured or destroyed altogether. However, if the processing wasn't bad enough, conventional or common chocolate today is also full of dairy and sugar, two substances that are in no way healthy or good for us, and negate even further any of the cacao's perhaps leftover remaining nutritional benefits. So let's examine some ingredients to really know for ourselves what are we eating so that we don't fall for the constant marketing tactics that keep telling us chocolate is good for us. So let's examine something like the Hershey's milk chocolate bar. The very first ingredient is cane sugar, the second ingredient, milk. And then we get into things like chocolate, cocoa butter, then more dairy, then lecithin from soy, and then flavorings. No wonder so many people find chocolate so addictive when it's based on sugar and dairy, both of which are highly addictive, and neither one of which are healthy for us. And so what you can see from these ingredients is that you're eating predominantly sugar and dairy, and also subjecting yourself to probable genetically modified organisms, as well as various additives via flavorings. And it gets even worse if we get into all the different flavored chocolate bars. Now you might be thinking, I know enough about chocolate to avoid those kinds, but I do eat the 70% or 90% dark chocolate. That's what's healthy, correct? Well, let's examine the following ingredient label from Lindt. As you can see, the first ingredient is chocolate, which is much better than the previous example, but the second ingredient is still sugar. And when we scan further down the list, we still have soy lecithin, a probable genetically modified organism. When we get right down to the source, when we strip away all the noise and misinformation, the results speak for themselves. Really, if you want to depend on any store-bought chocolate, the only way I recommend to perhaps enjoy some chocolate in its healthy form would be to go to a natural health food store and look through their chocolate section and then find the one that uses the cacao in its raw form, adds no refined or processed sugar, some kind of a least problematic sweetener, uses no dairy, and is also organic or GMO free. So what cacao should you be buying? Well, first and foremost, get to the source as much as possible. This means getting the cacao bean either in the crushed nib form or the powdered form. Secondly, look for cacao that is of the highest quality possible. Typically, this will mean a certified organic cacao product. Also considered a fair trade certified cacao product, as exploitation of farmers and workers is rampant when it comes to this food crop. My two recommendations for high quality organic raw cacao products are either Organic Traditions or Navitas. However, today with raw cacao's increased popularity, other companies have also begun to provide a high quality organic product. So now comes the fun part. Now that you know what form to get your cacao in and about its wonderful health and nutrition benefits when the cacao is kept with nutrient integrity in mind, then we get to play with it in various recipes as part of various snacks, meals, or desserts. So how you use your cacao will depend on the form you get. If you get the cacao nibs, the easiest thing to do with them is to basically sprinkle them into any dish that you would enjoy them in. Typically, this will include a whole grain breakfast bowl like an oatmeal or a quinoa bowl. You can also add them into raw cacao smoothies, or simply use the cacao nibs anywhere as you would pretty much chocolate chips. When it comes to the cacao butter form or any kind of pure cacao paste, these would be typically used for the actual chocolate making process. Now, when it comes to the cacao powder, this is what I find to be most versatile and what I usually recommend to have on hand for that odd chocolate treat that you may enjoy. With the cacao powder, you can make all sorts of raw sweet treats, such as various raw balls, bars, or squares. You can make all sorts of raw cakes and pies, and even crepes. You can make raw cacao chocolate sauce or frosting or fudge. For example, to make any of these, the four main ingredients that you will need is simply some coconut butter, some water, some raw cacao powder, and the least problematic sweetener, something like a natural maple syrup would do. You can also make raw cacao smoothies and puddings and even non-dairy ice cream. And of course, in its simplest form, you can use raw cacao to make a cup of hot chocolate. And this is a great way to enjoy a healthy and wholesome and also very soothing drink, especially for cold or winter months. It also is an excellent way to wean yourself off of coffee, as the brown, slightly bitter tones, as well as the warm beverage, can be a great substitute for the former. And of course, you can make all sorts of amazing homemade raw cacao chocolates, which I will be sharing with you about in our next section. So if you like chocolate, you will be happy to know that you don't have to depend on any of the store-bought conventional stuff. With just three ingredients, and in just a few minutes, you can have amazing homemade chocolate that is more optimally healthy than anything that you can find in the stores. If you search online, you will notice that there are all sorts of recipes to make your own chocolate. And when I first started to look into this, I realized that most of them do make the process a little bit more cumbersome than it needs to be. So for starters, you need three ingredients. You need cacao butter, you need raw cacao powder, and you need some kind of a healthier sweetener. What I would recommend typically is pure maple syrup. Next, you need a small saucepan. You don't need any fancy equipment to melt the cacao butter. Simply turn your stove on to a very low heat, one of the lowest settings that you can possibly have, and place the chunks of the cacao butter, the desired amount, into the little saucepan. Now, I don't use any specific proportions or quantities. Basically, I just work with a small portion as I would need it. And I don't even shred or, grate finely my cacao butter as I did at the beginning when I thought that there had to be a specific process. Making chocolate's actually very easy, and I found the process to be very forgiving as well. So simply start to melt the cacao butter in the little saucepan. Be sure to stay by the stove the whole time and use a fork to help break up the chunks and keep stirring constantly to help it melt uniformly, but not to overheat the cacao butter at any given time. As soon as the cacao butter has fully melted, turn off the heat. This is when you can begin to add your cacao powder. Now, how much? For perhaps about half a cup of melted cacao butter, I would add in at least 2 to 3 heaping tablespoons of cacao powder. But you can again play with your quantities. Basically, you want to add in the cacao powder and thicken up the mixture. So stir everything well together here, and then you can add in your sweetener. Now, typically about a tablespoon to 2 tablespoons, perhaps, of the maple syrup would be a good idea. Before you take it off the stove, taste it and see if it meets your flavor preferences. Now, other than that, you just need a high-quality food-grade silicone form for your chocolates, and simply carefully begin to transfer the chocolate into the particular shaped forms that you have. A very important tip here is to place a firm board, whether it's a tray or a cutting board of some sort, underneath the silicone tray before you start adding in the chocolate. You can do it after, but it does get a little bit trickier. This way, you'll be able to transfer the tray when you have finished pouring in all the chocolate to the refrigerator without having any spilling accidents. So once you have filled your entire tray, simply transfer this to the fridge and let them harden for about 4 hours. After about 4 hours, the chocolates should be more than done, and you can press them out into your desired dish. I recommend storing them in a sealed container and in the refrigerator, especially if you live in a warm climate. Other than that, they have an excellent shelf life. You can keep them in the fridge for days or weeks. You can also freeze them if you'd like to do that. And so that's all it takes to start. Three ingredients and just a few minutes, and you have delicious, decadent, and most importantly, healthy chocolates to enjoy. I hope you have fun making this base version, but of course, if you are ready to make some more creative versions, as well as perhaps different flavored homemade chocolate, perhaps add in some nuts or various crunchiness to them, et cetera, there's so many things you can do. And so for more sophisticated, optimally healthy chocolate making recipes, you can look online or consider a book like Raw Chocolate Treats: Healthy Recipes for the Chocolate Lover by Jessica Fenton. However, do note that this book is not for those who want a quick process, as it does get more complex and is for the true chocolate connoisseur out there. And so I hope you enjoy making your chocolates or just working with cacao in its most wholesome and natural form, a form that can truly benefit you, and not just your physical body, but also delight all of your senses as well. So I wish I could share one with you, but you'll have to try making them yourself to enjoy the goodness of these delicious, healthy, homemade chocolates. So creamy, so delicious. Enjoy, and see you next time.